and black, the Oakland Raiders.
And with that kick, we're underway. And Holmes has got it on the return. And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. Down at the 18. Amba Ali brings the quarterback down.
Outside linebackers in the NFL, they are such tremendous athletes. They can do everything. How about that play that time? Good move, good speed, gets to the quarterback and gets a sack.
Dalton looking long. Snatches it with one hand.
Johnson's going back to the huddle, and he's telling everybody, look up at the jumbotron, and let's watch a replay of me making this spectacular catch.
This play set up by the long gainer. The catch is made.
Well, the quarterback showed off his arm strength that time, didn't he? He put the football right on the money, on a line, right into the receiver's hands.
So they complete that one, yet it's still second down. Going deep. And they can't connect. And the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches. It'll be third down. LaMichael James is in the backfield. Finds his mark. And that's Jennings in on the stop.
If they're going to take away...
Coming to the line at the 19-yard line. James is in the backfield. First and 10. Makes the catch. A first drive and a first touchdown. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. This is Ginn running it out. Ball was out. Picking up the fumble. And now he's on the move.
Always hustle on the kick teams. And always be alert. That football came loose. What a job by the kicking team falling on it and getting that fumble. Well, the offense has done a good job getting down inside the 20 in the so-called red zone or green zone by some teams. But the defense, you can be a little more aggressive now. Because you don't have to worry about the length of the field. It is shortened, so take advantage of it and attack this offense a little more.
And now they'll try over again on second down. The Steelers line up, split backfield. Throws fields the pass. Incomplete as he was looking short. On that defensive line, a player to watch is Aaron Donald.
Aaron Donald showed everybody he was a high pick in the draft, and he deserved to be one because he had an outstanding rookie year.
The Steelers have it at the 29. He'll throw it over the middle. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down coming up.
The coach is going to go for it. The Raiders had at the line. Dime package. The defense stops the clock. Going for it on fourth down.
Making it are not very good, and that time it doesn't work. Good job by the defense being alert and knowing the situation.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Makes the play.
There's just so few quarterbacks who know how to throw it high and far anymore. Nice job that time by the quarterback. That throw was right on the money.
First down here. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Maurice Jones-Drew gets it here. Brought down at the 20. Here's the offensive line. And for this team, they are the lifeblood of the offense. When they're blocking well, this team can do some serious damage. Jones-Drew's going to receive the toss. A game-breaker. Touchdown. And with the second quarter looming, they've gotten themselves out of the hole with that touchdown.
Yeah, it just gives them confidence, Jim. Everybody, it picks up the defense. Of course, it picks up the offense. And it gives the coaches a whole new way to look at this football game as we get ready to finish off this first quarter.
Ready to step up and send this one down to the end zone. James going to test the coverage this time. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Steelers found themselves in good position the last time they had the ball, but chose to go for it on fourth down instead of bringing out the field goal unit. That proved to be costly.
Yeah, they got to remember who they're going against on the defensive side. This defensive coordinator is smart. He knows all these situations, and he guessed right with the offensive coordinator.
Boy, for as well as they drove the ball down the field the last time they had it, only to come up empty on that fourth down stop. How is this offense going to react on this drive?
I don't know. I can tell you from experience, it's demoralizing when you drive the football and you get in scoring territory where it's 3 or 7 and you come away with nothing. It's tough. So you got to pick yourself up and make it happen.
And it's Ali bursting through to stop the run.
The Raiders guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
And the second quarter is underway.
I'm looking like I'm gonna get it, you probably don't get it. I come in your house with a microphone looking like I'm about to set up a show in your kitchen. I'm out of my mind, but I feel like I'm in it. If I never make it, don't make any difference. I'm still gonna kill it, you know what the deal is. I never know telling when I'm in the building, and F is a monster. I am a villain. My music is sick and you don't know what ill is. You better get back, I don't write any filler. I write what I feel and I'm feeling a million, so you better shh, be quiet, you hear it? I'm about to lose it. I'm on a whole different level of music. Don't treat me like I have no clue how to do this. You better rethink what you're thinking and move it. Now picture me writing when I was a kid trying to make it in music. I think it is crazy. I spend all my money on studio time trying to get on my music so people can play it. Keep it 100, my... that I made. Go back to my moments album. Most of you people, you probably don't know what I'm saying. Hold up! What you witnessing now? Don't try to figure me out. I grab on that microphone, jump in the crowd. They was laughing at me. Who they laughing at now? Huh? I laugh at myself. Some people, they looking like wow. The moment you told me that you was a rapper, I couldn't believe it. You believe it now? Step in the booth and I'm murdering. You never heard of a rapper that killer like I do. I sleep on the couch in the studio. Stay up till 3 in the morning and write till I get more. The moment I wake up, I feel like I don't even sleep and I'm ready to put on my record. Well, thank you for playing. Maybe you burned it. But either way, I'm gonna wreck it.
Halfway home without a loss. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Raiders came into play here with two victories under their belt in their first two games. If they can repeat that for two more, they'll have themselves a title. They'll square off here against the New England Patriots.
We're underway here. He'll have a chance to take off. Stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Fitzpatrick's setting up now in the pistol. First down at the 19. Looking at every option. Great grab there. Snags it with one hand. What must it be like to be able to go down there and make a play like that? How about one-handed catch? That was special. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Breaks free. That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but... you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense is going to have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
Looking across the middle, and it's batted down. The outside threat for this offense is wide receiver DeAndre Hopkins out of Clemson.
Oh, man, a wide receiver from Clemson? I haven't heard that, you know, since last week. There's one on every single football team, but DeAndre Hopkins... good route runner, good size, and excellent speed. You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
First and goal from the 10. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle. Steven Tulloch is one of the leaders of this defensive unit.
Yeah, he absolutely is one of the leaders. Tells everybody what to do, and he is one tough guy inside, and you can never get enough toughness when you talk about defense in the NFL. Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Third and goal from the 10. Jones-Drew takes it. Toss play. What a way to start the game. First possession touchdown. Still 3.5 quarters of football to play, but that touchdown gives them the lead here early.
Yeah, I know. There's a long way to go. There's no doubt it. But you've got to like your situation and the feel that your football team has getting that score and being on top.
And this is Ginn running it out. And they're all him at the 18-yard line. Matthews is lined up directly behind the quarterback here. First down at the 18. Brown's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Nothing drives a coach crazier than a false start penalty. The Patriots come to the line with a bunch set. First and 15 to go. Marvin Brown with the catch.
Jim Nance, that was the old fly route. When we were kids, that's what they called it. See if you can fly by the defensive back. He did that time. Nice throw and catch.
The catch is made by Tim Wright. Johnson's there to make the tackle. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. And the pass is thrown to Wright. He has it. They've moved the chains with about a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
No margin for error from just outside the goal line. Patriots in for the score.
Tight ends are becoming a bigger and bigger part of the passing offense in the NFL. It leads to a touchdown this time. Nice job by the big guy just getting in position to make the catch.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. And this is Ginn running it out. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. First down at the 24. Launches it down the field. Comes down with, oh, the defender tips it out.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Ryan Fitzpatrick under center. Toss to the outside. Keeps his legs moving. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Jones Drew is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
The Raiders take it from the 38. Can't find the target on the pass underneath.
Receivers open coming across the field, but sometimes these short throws are tough, and the quarterback throws it too far in front.
Second and 10. Toss to the outside. And that gains one. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day. We're early in this one, but already a crucial third and long play coming up.
These are tough situations. What are you going to do on the offensive side? There's only so much you can do. If I was the defense, I would look for a screen.
Down the field. Incomplete. Almost going in the other direction.
The Raiders put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
Again from the 11. Gains 11. The Patriots offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
That's a false start. The Patriots lined up. Everybody split out wide. Kaepernick from the gun. loose ball that had a lot of heat on it. This will probably be the last play of the quarter. Kaepernick's going to take off with it. He steps out. Back here to start quarter two. We are deadlocked right now in a game that has seen its fair share of defense.
Yeah, it's kind of fun to watch, isn't it? I love defenses when they come out and they just establish the line of scrimmage and beat the offense up. That's what we've seen so far, and I think it's going to continue.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Patriots in the end zone. Kaepernick, second touchdown of the game.
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. He wanted more excitement, more tension, more decision making. It's the second guess in the NFL, and now they're going to have it. This two-point conversion, more teams are going to do it because they don't want to kick the extra point from the 15-yard line.
And this is Ginn running it out. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Raiders stalled on their last drive, forced a punt. So now the offense comes back out onto the field.
Yeah, they're coming back out. They lack confidence, and I understand why. They came out, couldn't get anything done. The defense was flying around making the plays. They got to change the tempo of this game. Not too often you see a quarterback on these deep, high throws overthrow these speedy wide receivers. It shows you what a great arm he has. Overthrows him by a couple yards. Well, it's a good job by the linebackers moving around. They're trying to confuse the offensive line. The Raiders had time. They can't get big yards, but the throw and catch picks up a few, and his third down's much easier with this situation.
Third and four coming up following that completion. Maurice Jones-Drew lined up in the backfield. Gets it out for the completion. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains. That's reception number two for him. Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line. Fitzpatrick's going to be in the pistol here. First down at the 39. And it's thrown incomplete. The Raiders have it at the 39. Has the grab.
You know, when you catch in the football, there's nothing like catching the pass, whether it's short or long, and breaking a tackle and getting a couple extra yards. That makes the quarterback have some confidence in you, and he'll start looking for you more.
First and 10. Reaches out and grabs it. Good yardage picked up on that call.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch, and gets a first down.
Fitzpatrick's completion percentage, 50% on the day. The Raiders at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
The best way to keep the other offense on the sidelines is just keep marching down the field and picking up those first downs. What a good job by the offense.
This will probably be the last play before the two-minute warning. Throws the pass. And that's Stephen Tulloch who brings him down. And we've reached the two-minute warning in this one. Coming to the line at the one. The Patriots lined up in the nickel. Power surge for six. Touchdown.
Well, this quarterback is not afraid to score on the goal line, that's for sure. Not afraid about taking a hit from one of those big, mean defensive players. He runs a quarterback sneak and gets a touchdown. The defensive line saw something the offense is doing. Look at them all shifting to the right.
And intercepted. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. The Patriots prepared to return the kick. Cox is going to test the coverage here. Williams in on the tackle. That return's good for about 22. The Patriots offense ready to continue its recent run here as they've scored the last two times they've had it, Phil.
Let's look at it from the defensive side. You know, what do you think they're thinking? Oh, my gosh, what's coming next? Because everything the offense has tried so far has worked.
Looking to go deep. On target. A foot race. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and, hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
That's a timeout by the D.
Quarterback. He's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Got the touchdown, got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do. And you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Raiders offense coming back onto the field after a touchdown drive the last time they had it. And they certainly attacked that secondary and got there via the pass.
Well, Jim, let me ask you this. How would you like to be the defensive coordinator right now? Because you're over there. You don't know what's going to happen. No matter what you call, you feel like, hey, the quarterback's hot. He's probably going to beat what we're trying to do.
The Raiders will take the snap from the 25. He's in the clear. The 20, the 10, going to take it home for the touchdown.
Well, just think about what it takes. It takes a quarterback with a talented arm to make this type of throw, and it takes a talented receiver to make this catch. They do both, and it results in a nice touchdown.
The Raiders ready to kick it away. And this is Ginn running it out. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Patriots are having a very good day of it offensively, but still, they have not been able to put this game out of reach, Phil.
Well, the defense is struggling, that's why, Jim. And, you know, that's okay. Some days, one side of the football is going to struggle more than the other side. So right now, it's up to the offense to keep being aggressive and keep scoring points.
Wants to go deep, and it's incomplete.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, the football falls incomplete.
Second down after the incompletion.
Hey, 91. 91. 91. 91. 91. 91. 91. 91. 91.
The Patriots are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Justin Tuck has a sack.
Hard to get these hits against quarterbacks now, these blindside hits, because everybody's worried about getting hit as a quarterback. The protections, all the smart things they do, get rid of the football fast, but they couldn't stop at that time. Big hit.
Loss of three on the play. The Patriots come to the line, and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. The Patriots take it from the 23. The pass falls incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series. And it'll be Colquitt back to punt. And it's a fake. They're running a fake. It's intercepted.
Well, anytime you run a fake punt and you let somebody throw the football besides the quarterback, even though the play is there and everybody's wide open, you still have a chance of not making it work. Why? Because the guy throwing it is not an NFL quarterback.
The Raiders take it from the 38. Has his man. Graham's there to take him down. Tight ends are absolutely crucial to what an offense does now, and we're seeing why here in this first half, partner.
Yeah, we are, Jim, and I think it started years ago when the New England Patriots would come on the field and use multiple tight ends. It was a good way to fool the defense and be able to throw it to the tight end, and it's working so far here today for this offense.
The ball is jarred loose.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
Coming to the line at the 27. Fitzpatrick's lining up in the pistol. Second down and 10. Secures it with two hands. Oakland Raiders, touchdown.
Nothing like it for a quarterback, I'll tell you that. I loved it. Throw a little short pass and just root your guy on and watch him score. Touchdown, pretty exciting stuff.
Extra point is good. The Raiders getting ready to kick it off. And this is Ginn running it out. Made right around the 26-yard line. The Patriots offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points.
First down at the 26. Brown's got the catch and the first. Third catch today so far. The Patriots are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. Colin Kaepernick will be taking this one from the gun.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
The Raiders defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. First down at the 37. Catch made by Riley Cooper. And Gaines there to make the stop. The Patriots will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Coming to the line at the 15. First down following the long play. And the quarterback is tackled by Bruce Irvin.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
Touchdown, New England. A big touchdown right there. They're almost sure to take the lead to the locker room with that score.
All touchdowns are big, man. They're all exciting. They all make you feel great. And right now, the offense, they are feeling great about what they did on that last drive.
My goodness, what a hit. And the ball falls incomplete. The Patriots now, no doubt, will onside kick it. And as hard as they try, they fail to recover the onside kick. The Raiders retaking the field here, and they have been prolific today offensively. Hard to believe they're trailing right now, given all the points they've scored.
Yeah, listen, there's nothing you can do about it. Don't worry about winning and losing at this point. Just go out there and do your job. If you do that, that's going to lead you to another score, and that's all you can do on the offensive side.
The first half is complete. Larry Ridley ready to take things over back in the studios, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Okay, Larry, looking sharp back in that studio. Thank you for that. And now we're ready to get the third quarter underway as these teams take the field. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Patriots take the field here in the second half, looking to extend their lead in this one, partner.
Yeah, you know what you do if halftime is over. You come out here, you're not sure what the new game plan is going to be, but feel your way into the game. Don't take a chance early and turn the football over. Look at the linebackers moving around. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
First down at the 21. Kaepernick's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under. The Patriots are in front thanks to their quarterback. Kaepernick's been unstoppable so far.
He has been unstoppable, hasn't he? When your quarterback is hot, keep giving the football to him. They've done it, and he has rewarded the coaches. Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Brandon Lloyd with the catch.
That's a nice play at that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That is a great feeling.
Now first and 10. Kaepernick now on the move. Ducks out of bounds.
The Patriots are really a true football team. Their defense, we know it's good. They don't want to just rely on it. The offense, nice job picking up that first down. Eat the clock up. Keep the pace of the game on your side. Small lead here in the second half. That was a good job.
Double tight end formation. First down at the 38. Cooper's got it on a pass that had some heat. The Raiders with a nickel look here on defense. The Patriots will use a timeout here early in the second half. Second down.
Hey, 91, 91.
There's some shifting around in the backfield.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
The Patriots snap it at the 31. Got a big lane. Gains 18.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
First down and 10. Matthews on the screen. Matthews is lined up in a single back formation. False start, and that sets the offense back 5 yards.
Yeah, listen, false start, and it can be the littlest thing. A little flinch, and it doesn't look like much, but everybody in the stadium can see it, and so can the official.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. The Raiders with 2 extra defensive backs in the dime. 2nd and long. Pass is intercepted.
This defensive coordinator, he is one aggressive dude. He keeps going after this offense, and finally he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
No margin for error here with the offense. Fitzpatrick set in the pistol. Airing it out. Nice catch.
The Raiders just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense. The defensive line, they're all shifting to the right. I think they're expecting a run over there.
Reaches out and snatches it. The Raiders still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Fitzpatrick's tried to keep his team in it any way he can.
Well, a couple things, Jim. You can't blame the quarterback because they're trailing. He has been outstanding here today. The offensive line, the play calling, all good.
Jones Drew lined up in the backfield. The Raiders will take the snap from the 45. Catch made. And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first.
That's a really good throw and catch, and they get the first down, Jim. That's what you want to do. Pick up that first down. Now you give your offense 3 more opportunities.
Fitzpatrick's completion percentage, 60% on the day. First down at the 47. That brings the play to an end.
Tulloch's probably going to go to the sideline and tell him, hey, I got such a good pair of hands after that interception that I should play some tight end. I don't know about that, but I'll tell you this, he is one good linebacker.
What a nice spot to begin this drive. The Patriots have it at the 34. To the outside, Matthews.
Matthews is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
The Patriots will take the snap from the 30. Riley Cooper with the catch. That's his 3rd catch of the day.
What a nice corner route run by the receiver. He fakes the defensive back out. And look at the quarterback. He knows that little move. When he stuck it, he led him out to the corner. Nice throw, nice catch.
This next play will take place at the 11.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Here is the first snap of the final quarter. Jarring hit that time. Knocks the ball free.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by
the 10. Out to Cooper. Cooper's met after a gain of 8. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
Touchdown, New England Patriots. Tammy's 2nd touchdown of the game. The Patriots for the extra point. inside of the uprights. The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. And this is Ginn running it out. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. The Raiders offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Gets it out for the completion. And he'll step out. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Jones Drew on the screen. And that's a gain of 9.
The Raiders understand, just get whatever yards you can every time you run a play. That's what they do that time. It's a short completion. But look what position it puts them here. In on third down, this is something they can handle.
Fitzpatrick's completion percentage, 60% on the day. The Raiders approach the line, and they're going with their jumbo package. Another third down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch.
When you pick up first downs against the defense, they will get tired. That time, nice job by the offense getting the first down, even though they're losing here in the game. The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
He makes the catch.
Jim, here in the fourth quarter, when you're down, what you want to do is just keep that football moving. That time it's a short throw, he gets a completion. Good job.
The Raiders snap it at the 41. Ryan Fitzpatrick throws the deep pass. Taking another look at the stats here, we have a wide receiver who has put together a complete game, Phil.
It has been a tremendous game, Jim, no doubt about it. Now we understand why guys want to be wide receivers in the NFL instead of running backs. So many more ways to get the football and much easier to make plays happen once you get it.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. Maurice Jones-Drew lined up in the backfield. Jones-Drew's got it. Screenplay.
Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Loss of 3 on the play. Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way. Second and 13. Had it for a moment, but then lost it on the hit.
Well, when you get in a situation like this, Jim, and you get third and long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back, because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short.
Touchdown and drawing close.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
The pass is complete.
Hey, interesting decision. I think we're going to see more two-point conversions in the league this year than ever before, because kicking an extra point from the 15-yard line, it's not a gimme anymore.
And this is Ginn running it out. Williams going to make the tackle. That return's good for about 18. The Patriots offense doesn't want to do anything to screw this one up at this point, Phil. They've got the lead, and they've got the football late in the game.
You're such a positive guy, Jim. I like that comment. Go down there and tell them that. Don't screw it up. But what do you do in a situation like this? I always like to try to draw the defense off sides on first down, because they're anxious and you can take advantage of that.
Matthews takes his spot in the backfield. First down at the 17. The ball is taken out of his hands.
Brown is going to be so mad at himself for dropping that football, because receivers, you never know when your chance is going to come. And then finally, you get open, they call a play where you're the primary.
Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. Matthews lined up in the backfield. Two hands on the football and has the catch. The Raiders stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second.
Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. And incomplete as Brown can't hold on.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
He's into the open. And now Kaepernick will give himself up.
That's a really smart job that time by the quarterback. Pick up all the yards you can, and before you're going to get hit, slide in there like you're going. To second base.
Coming to the line at the 48. Empty backfield look for Kaepernick here. First down at the 48. The ball is knocked out.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
Second down here. The Raiders defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. He'll throw it over the middle. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands. The Raiders will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point. This next play comes from the 30. Kaepernick will be taking the snap out of the pistol. First down at the 30. Matthew. And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
Well, the offense just had a wonderful sustained drive for the touchdown. They're happy. The defense, of course, they're not. They just got beat up all the way down the field and gave up that touchdown.
And this is Ginn running it out. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Raiders offense takes the field, and they are absolutely in desperate need of a big-time drive here to put points on the board.
The one thing we do know, since you are behind, the defense most likely is going to be very conservative the first couple calls. So make sure you have play calls to take advantage of the fact that they're going to be very conservative on the defensive side. Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, they can make a big play.
The Raiders break huddle and show a jumbo look. He hauls it in. The tackle's made, and the first down is picked up. That's reception number 7 for him. First down. Pressure on every snap now.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
The defender able to knock it away. So coming off an incomplete deep pass, there just aren't that many plays you can call right here when you're desperate.
No, there's not many. And look, you got to throw it down there. You got to hope for your skilled athletes to make the play. The defense was ready that time. I expect another deep throw on this upcoming play.
What a job by the receiver, climbing the mountain and coming down with the reception.
Wow, climbing the mountain, that is a new one. What a good job. You're right. These wide receivers in the NFL now, they can go up and make unbelievable catches. And remember, you can't hit them until they come to the ground. That gives them a little more courage.
Is every win sweet, or are the close ones that much more satisfying than just blowing someone out for 60 minutes?
Well, the close ones are more satisfying because the tension is there longer. And the longer you're under tension, when it finally comes to fruition, you win, it just makes it that much more exciting, Jim.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA's.
Why you got your back against the wall?